Hello everyone, and first of all, I want to thank you for joining in such a big number, so for deciding to attend the presentation. So basically, this is a project that I've been working almost from the beginning, so I have more than 8 years that I've been working on this project. It's a home automation solution that InnoG is building together with iQuest, and it's a great system that basically brings your house to life. That's its mission. So next, I will give you some insights on InnoG, on what the product does, and also what's the iQuest input in it. Okay, first of all, about InnoG. InnoG is a big energy company. It has more than 40,000 employees. These employees serve more than 23 million customers. So it's a pity, it's a big number. Also, here, InnoG is one of the European leaders in terms of grid and retail. And it also has a big business in renewable energy, such as wind. The brand name itself, so InnoG, stands for innovation, energy, and technology. Now, the story of iQuest working for InnoG started back in 2009. Then InnoG decided to develop a product that will help the regular home users to save energy, to cut utility costs, and provide more comfort. So basically, this is how the entire smart home project and the InnoG iQuest collaboration started. From a very high-level perspective, the product is it's a pretty simple one. So at the core, we have a smart home controller, which you have in each user's home. Now, these smart home controllers connect to a series of devices, so it can control and configure them. The user can connect to the smart home controller and hence control the entire system via the mobile apps or via the browser. From a high-level perspective, it's pretty simple. Now, right from the beginning, from where we started to work on the project, we have two key principles. Now, these two key principles we try to follow over the years while expanding and continuously developing the system. So the first principle is simplicity. So what we wanted for the user is to have an easy way to use the system and integrate new devices. So even now, for most of the devices, everything that the user needs to do in order to integrate it in his configuration is to pull the device out of the box, connect it, plug it into the socket, or connect the batteries, and then there are a few clicks in the UI application, everything is done. So the big advantage here is that you don't need a special technician, wiring, or any technical expertise. So it's easy to use. Of course, we also have among our users some that are passionate about electronics. So recently on the Facebook group, we saw a user that used a standard switch to control a magnetic valve, so custom made by him, in order to enable voice control for the hot tub, for controlling the water. So he can say, okay, start the water, stop the water, the hot tub. But this is a particular scenario. What we want is to offer simple solutions for the typical user. Now, the second principle that we follow when developing the system is we wanted to have a versatile system. We wanted to have a system that is highly customizable by the user. So we didn't want it to have just a set of hard-coded rules. We wanted to enable the user to make the best out of his devices. So really to use the capabilities of these devices. And I will give you an example here. It's a little bit complex, but I think it will point out what the system is able to do. So for instance, one of the simple devices that we support is the motion detection. And it's a very simple device. It detects motion. When motion detects it, it sends a signal. Now this device, besides the motion detection, it also has embedded a luminosity sensor. So we can feel variation. So using the system, you can define a custom process. So in case light variation is detected, let's say that light goes under 50%, you can control a totally different device that runs on a totally different protocol. Let's say a Hue lamp, which of course can be positioned in another room. And you can say, okay, when this happens, automatically, without any user interaction, without having any wiring between the devices, the light on the Hue should go red, 50% red, let's say. Also, based on this luminosity, you could, for instance, program an alarm to make a small, play a small sequence of sound, let's say with a low volume and a high pitch. You can even send an SMS with it. And everything is configurable, so the user can easily do this via the configuration. So, of course, we support all kinds of interesting scenarios. Over the year, the platform has grown, so we have support for many devices and many functions. Now, some of the most used are the sunrise sunset. So basically, we have a sensor, and you can program your roller shutters to go up 5 minutes before the sunrise, so you can enjoy it. You can put alarm to sound so that you don't miss it there. There are also all kind of typical scenarios, like turning off the radiator when the window is open, so you can save energy. You can get email or SMS if smoke is detected. So we also have some predefined sets, but the important point to keep in mind is that everything is configurable. So basically, the limit, we don't have a limit to how many devices you can configure, basically. So the only limitation is given by the user imagination or by the number of devices that we support. Another key factor is related to the diversity. So we have, among the years, we got to support a lot of devices. We have more than 60 devices integrated in the platform. So it's not just a system with 3 or 4 devices in the closed loop. So we have in-house devices developed from partner companies, InnoG partner companies. So these are plugs, switches, dimmers, electrical meters. But we also support in the system integration with third-party systems. So these are completely independent from the smart home, but still you can integrate and control them. So we have, for instance, the Philips Hue, so we can control, you can have nice lamps and nice dimming effects. We have the Samsung camera, so basically you can take a picture whenever the front door is open. So you can get that picture and look at it. Or you can make the picture at the sunset if you combine it with the roller shutters. We have integration with the Yale door lock, Miele appliances, Alco mowers, Netatmo weather station. So we have a lot of integrations. We have also integrations with Amazon Alexa. So here you can do voice control. So the key factor is that we wanted to offer the user the possibility to do all kind of different combination. These three factors that I enumerated, so the simplicity, the versatility, and the diversity, so these are also the key differentiators that we have compared to other home automation systems. Okay. Next, I want to go and talk a little bit about what's iQuest's role in this, so how iQuest helped developing this platform. Before going there, just another important aspect. So the entire system, so the entire backend, it's exposed via RESTful API. So basically, you are not restricted in using only the official clients that InnoG provides. So for now, the API is restricted only to selected partners. But from a technical perspective, all you will need to do is get an ID for your client and a password. And that you can do by asking Wolfgang there in the sixth row, so if you want to do something like this. Of course, we have also API documentation that might help you in the process. Okay. Then I will go to tell you a little bit about what's iQuest's role in developing this product. So iQuest is involved in all phases of product development, starting from the strategic planning, going all the way to concept, development, deployment, production launch, and support after the launch. So we have also product care there. And we are covering all the disciplines, starting from project management, requirements analysis and design, implementation, testing, and also that product care. So in the strategic planning part, what we do is we look first at the big picture. So here we take a new feature and we analyze it and see how it could be added to the system. We also take a look at the high-level timeline. We have a look on how this will impact on the existing solution architecture. And we even decide if we already know from a technical perspective how we can do this, or we require some proof of concepts. Most of the times, it is in this phase that also the testing strategy is being defined. So exactly how will the testing be done? The system integrates with a lot of third parties. And there are also other suppliers, especially for the hardware. So then it's important to have all this in mind. Now considering the analysis and design discipline. Here, on iQuest side, we offer a team of architects. The team of architects is led by a solution architect, also from iQuest side. And we are basically responsible for the solution architecture and the software architecture on the specific components. Now, this solution architecture is also discussed and agreed with the solution architect on the side of the client. Regarding the implementation discipline, here it's worth mentioning that the system has pretty much three big components. So we have first the software that is running on the box, on the smart home controller in the user's home. Then we have the backend and the RESTful API. And we have the UI. Now, currently, iQuest is responsible for the developing and testing all of these. So for doing this, we have a cross-technology team. We have people from a Microsoft department. They are the oldest on the project. They joined right from 2009, from the beginning. We have C++, we have web development, we have native. So all kind of different technologies working together here. On the testing side, it's also an interesting aspect. So we have a strong team in iQuest here in Cluj. They do more than just testing. They are involved in the development process right from the beginning. So from the concept phase, they help clarify requirements and use cases. They have a lot of experience in the system, so they can provide valuable input. But we are not the only one testing on the platform. So given the nature of the product, every product owner from Innogy side has an installation at home. So they are very passionate and active platform users. It's also a source of interesting bugs coming from their side here. The last point that I want to mention here is related to the managed services. So deployment in production system is done by the client IT department. There we also offer support for big deployments. And we have a dedicated product care team. Now, this team is responsible for delivering critical hotfixes or service packs. Or it may happen, you notice that we have a lot of integration with third-party systems. They change their APIs. They don't always notify us with a lot of time up front. So we are in the position that we need to release quickly an update so that our customers are not affected. Now, for covering all these responsibilities, we have a team of more than 60 people on iQuest side. But of course, the number is not everything, so I want to tell you also a little bit about the engagement model that we are using. And on this project, we are using a local nearshore engagement model. So we choose to do so because this home automation context landscape is a very complex and highly dynamic. So you can get offers from partners trying to connect to your platform. Also, there are a lot of ideas running around. So it's not only about finding the technical solution for integrating a partner or a feature. It's also about thinking, okay, do we need to have this feature in the system? Is it something good for the system? Do we want it in this form? Now, this is why it's very important for us to be close to the customer. And we have a team working on site in InnoG offices in Dortmund, and they are covering the business analysis and the solution architecture. So basically, when the client wants to validate an idea or discuss a potential partnership, we don't need to set up any business trips or, I don't know, send any documentation. It's just going next office, open the door, and okay, say, can we do it or not? Still related to the local nearshore engagement model, an important aspect is the regular management present at the client side. So, like I mentioned, we have a big team. It's a pretty huge team here, more than 60 people working. We are working on different streams, so we don't have just one. We have many parallel streams ongoing, many projects. Each one with his specific constraints, specific timelines, specific scope, quality requirements. Also, the product owner is not just one. So basically, you have a board of product owners. And this is why it's important to be often at the client side, to really see potential conflicts, to see issues that could appear in the timeline. And align those. Also, of course, we are lucky here in Cluj and in Sibiu because we have direct flights to Dortmund three times per week, so it's easy to go there. So it's even easier than going to Brasov from Cluj. So it's very good for us. Here also, the client comes often on our side. So not only the management and the product owners, but also designers who are working better with the team this way. No, we have also other trips that we organize. So, for instance, members of the team go on site for production deployments or for testing specific devices in InnoG laboratory. So, we have also big devices like heat pumps, PVs installation, and those are not practical to bring to Cluj. And those we go and test there. I will go quickly to the last slide because I'm getting signs from. So last topic is about how we do the program management. So here, having that many streams running in parallel with that many product owners and different constraints, it's important to set up a general collaboration model. So it's important to have some guidelines or some practices that we want to follow on each project. Now, how we achieve this? We achieve it mostly by having monthly steerings in Dortmund, so basically at InnoG site, and there all the project managers from Microsoft go there, and we have a discussion with the upper management from the product factory, and we have RAG status on the relevant KPI for each running project. So we have RAG status for scope, timeline, quality, and so on. It's a high-level status. We don't go, we don't do deep dives. We just look where issues are. So the green ones are almost always skipped. So we just focus on the other ones. Okay. Besides this, we have also weekly status meeting. These are online meetings again with the project managers and the technical leads. And in these ones, we do the deep dive. So really going to the topics and making sure that there aren't any conflicts. So as an important point, at the third floor, we have a demo panel, we have an installation, you can play with it, so we are all welcome during the breaks or during the day to come downstairs and you can experience the installation. I also can give you more insights because there we have more time for that. So these were the topics that I wanted to show, so thank you for your attention.